Hello students, welcome to the class on current affairs, and in this class we will be dealing with China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. This topic relates to international diplomacy or international relations. In this topic we will be discussing about the effects of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor in strengthening China's hegemony and the cost of it to China, the benefits of it to China. And secondly, we will be learning about should India participate in it. And then lastly, the prospective increase in the scope of CPEC, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. Now first of all, let us understand what is this China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. Now before we understand this China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, we need to understand the importance of lines of communication. Now when it comes to lines of communication, basically two important lines of communication are by way of road, railway, and by way of sea lanes. Now, lanes of communication are also important because these lanes of communication helps in strengthening the economic relationship between two countries. It helps in easy accessibility of trade. It helps in easy accessibility of energy resources. So, three benefits hoge hamare paas agar achhe hamare paas lanes of communication hai. Trade easily conduct kar sakte hain. एनर्जी का अवेलेबिलिटी बहुत इजीली हो सकता है एंड देन वी कैन आल्सो स्ट्रेंथन डिप्लोमेटिक रिलेशनशिप विद सम अदर कंट्री. सो दीज आर द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ लेन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन. नाउ चाइना ऑफ लेट हैज इम्बाइब्ड कंप्लीटली द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ लेन्स ऑफ कम्युनिकेशन एंड इट इज बिकॉज ऑफ दिस China is working on numerous projects by which it can get easily connected to the Asian, South Asian countries, to the East Asian countries, to the Middle East countries, and to the European countries. Basically, China is working on connectivity, communication, and interlinkages. Now, China wants the 21st century to be the century of complete integration, because China believes that by instituting lanes of communication, it can integrate half of the world, at least half of the world, economically and strategically. So this is the reason why China has been so much obsessive about the lanes of communication, sea lanes, road lanes, trail lanes, etc. Now China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. Now China has started this economic corridor by which it will be connecting the Xinjiang province in China to the Baloch province in Pakistan, and in Baloch province there is Gwadar port, very important Gwadar port. Now by this China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, China will be having direct access to the Persian Gulf region. China will be having an easy access to the Indian Ocean. China will be having access to the easy availability of energy resources. China will be able to play a more substantive and phenomenal role in the Middle East countries, in the diplomacy of the Middle East. China will be able to assert itself completely over the Middle East countries. So that will be the benefit that the China will be accruing from Xinjiang to Gwadar, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. So China will save a lot of amount that it spends on logistics. Lesser of the distance will have to be covered to the Middle East countries. Tentatively, it will cut the distance by 10,000 kilometers. 10,000 kilometers means a huge distance. It's about 3 to 4 days of travel by road, or by sea lane, that's a travel of about 20 days. So it takes a lot of time. So this is the distance that it will be cutting through this China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. So by way, it will also be hegemonizing this entire region. Now, another important question, should India participate in it or not? Now, if India will be participating in China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, now it will be giving a kind of legitimacy to China's interference in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Because the most important thing about this corridor is that from Xinjiang, it will be passing through Gilgit, Baltistan region. Now this region, it lies in Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. India, in the diplomatic circles, India in its diplomacy has never accepted that the POK belongs to Pakistan. It has always asserted that Pakistan is occupying India's territory. Though reality, the region lies in Pakistan. But there has always been demand. So by entering this agreement, entering this corridor, China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, India will be kind of giving up its demand. It will be like giving legitimacy to the Pakistan's acquisition of Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. Ek dhang se hum jaiz thehra denge ki jo occupation Pakistan ne iska kiya hua hai Pakistan-occupied Kashmir ka, wo sahi hai. Jo itni der se hum duniya ko samjhane ki koshish kar rahe hain कि पाकिस्तान ने कब्जा किया हुआ है कि हिंदुस्तान की टेरिटरी के ऊपर वो सब कुछ शेल्फ डाउन हो जाएगा. Then we have the prospective increase in the scope of China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. Now this corridor has a potential to continue till Chabahar port. Now this is the port that is in Iran and it lies very close to Gwadar port. There are chances in the future, this is very very important, there are chances in the future that China and Pakistan might try to extend this China-Pakistan Economic Corridor to China-Pakistan-Iran Economic Corridor by linking Bloch Gwadar port with Chabahar port. And if that will be done, in that case, the advantage that India has gained vis-a-vis China in the Persian Gulf region will be done away with. So India ke paas advantage hai, wo khatam ho jayega. अगर ये वाला एडवांटेज खत्म हो जाएगा तो इंडिया ने जो डिप्लोमेटिकली ईरान को एंगेज किया हुआ है इतने सालों से वो सारा कुछ शेल्फ डाउन हो जाएगा. सो इंडिया हैज टू मेक अ टफ डिसीजन ऑफ शुड इट बी पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन दिस और शुड इट नॉट बी पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन इट. सो दिस इज अ काइंड ऑफ अ वेरी बिग क्वेश्चन दैट इंडिया हैज टू आंसर. So this was all for the class. Now in order to read more on this, please visit brainyias.com. If you want to have a brainy map on this, please visit brainyias.com. So this was all for the day. Bye bye, take care, have a nice day.